Frida, stop. Stop fucking Teddy, please. You don't even have a penis and you're fucking Teddy. Please stop. We are listening to Do Rain's Barn Dance Set from her Infinite Variety Celtic Women in Music and Song. Cherish the ladies. Tree, serpent, and crocodile worship. Object of horror or of adoration. Men have for the serpent an implacable hatred or prostrate themselves before its genius. Lie calls it. Prudence claims it. Envy carries it in its heart. And eloquence on its caduceus. In hell it arms the whip of the furies. In heaven, eternity makes of it its symbol. De Chateaubriand. The Ophites asserted that there were several kinds of genii, from God to man, that the relative superiority of these was ruled by the degree of light that was accorded to each. And they maintained that the serpent had to be constantly called upon and to be thanked for the signal service it had rendered humanity. For it taught Adam that if he ate of the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, he would raise his being immensely by the learning and wisdom he would thus acquire. Such was the exoteric reason given. It is easy to see whence the primal idea of this dual, Janus-like character of the serpent, the good and the bad. This symbol is one of the most ancient, because the reptile preceded the bird and the bird the mammal. Thence the belief, or rather the superstition, of the savage tribes who think that the souls of their ancestors live under this form, and the general association of the serpent with the tree. The legends about the various things it represents are numberless, but, as most of them are allegorical, they have now passed into the class of fables based on ignorance and dark superstition. For instance, when Philostratus narrates that the natives of India and Arabia fed on the heart and liver of serpents in order to learn the language of all the animals, the serpent being credited with that faculty, he certainly never meant his words to be accepted literally. As will be found more than once as we proceed, the serpent and dragon were the names given to the wise ones, the initiated adepts of olden times. Ah, it was their wisdom and their learning that were devoured or assimilated by their followers. Whence the allegory? When the Scandinavians Sigurd, is fabled to have roasted the heart of Fafnir, the dragon, whom he had slain, becoming thereby the wisest of men, it meant the same thing. Again the name. Sigurd had become learned in the runes and magical charms. He had received the word from an initiate of that name, or from a sorcerer, after which the latter died, as many do, after passing the word. Epiphanius lets out a secret of the Gnostics while trying to expose their heresies. The Gnostic Ophites, he says, had a reason for honoring the serpent. It was because he taught the primeval men the mysteries. Verily so, but they did not have Adam and Eve in the garden in their minds when teaching this dogma, but simply that which is stated above. The Nagas of the Hindu and Tibetan adepts were human Nagas, serpents, not reptiles. Moreover, the serpent has ever been the type of consecutive or serial rejuvenation, of immortality, and time. The numerous and extremely interesting readings, the interpretations and facts about serpent worship given in the natural Genesis are very ingenious and scientifically correct. But they are far from covering the whole of the meanings implied. They divulge only the astronomical and physiological mysteries, with the addition of some cosmic phenomena. Ha! Anantasheshanaga!